If you want to make it in the country music industry, this is the city you have to make it in.
But you can't sing on an empty stomach. And the best place to get great food at bargain basement price is Arnolds, a Nashville institution and what's known as a meat and three restaurant.
What is a meat and three, I hear you ask? Well, it's a wholesome meal consisting of a filling serving of meat with a choice of three side dishes.
And for the past 32 years, Arnold's Dine-Up has been serving up plates of steaming hot food to the city's hungry musicians.
But even when they strike gold, they come back for more. The food is that good. And owner Rose has met them all.
This is a wall of fame.
It is.
Because you've got amazing singer-songwriters like John Prine, Chet Atkins. I mean, it's endless.
Dolly Parton.
And they've all been in here to eat.
Yes, it's amazing. But and I think, again, for them, it was that they are home and they're one of us. And stood in line like everybody else.
Arnold's open at 11 and close at 2, but packs in 300 customers every day.
It's a tall order, but it runs like clockwork.
How do you get 300 people fed, watered, take the money in such a short time?
A lot of fast talking. I don't know. But smiling. Thank you very much. And everybody leaves happy. It's like magic. This area was all industrial when we first started. So that's who our customers were, people that had that 20-minute break, 30-minute break.
On the menu today are three of Arnold's most popular mains, roast beef, ham, and of course, meatloaf. They are served with side dishes like candied yams, white beans, and macaroni cheese.
What would Dolly Parton have if she'd come in here?
Chicken livers. She loved chicken livers and the chocolate pie.
Fantastic.
And that's the great thing about a restaurant like this. It's part of Nashville. The character and the personality of the city. And hats off to you because it's fantastic. Yeah.
The mid-morning rush is about to start. So we've offered to help out. Dave lends a hand carving the meat.
Another bean.
While I learn how to wait tables.
He's doing well. He's in the flow. He's in the zone. The dude's off. I tell you what, I think I've got the easy end of the stick. I haven't started to do anything yet, and when I do, I'm going to follow Will. So, hey, I'm laughing. So, Will, what's the secret of bussing tables, man?
Well, I would say speed and the customers. That's all. That's it.
Just shout ham and beef ladies, please.
Ham and beef ladies.
Half of each.
Half of each. Half a ham, half a beef.
Yeah.
For ladies.
For ladies.
Half a ham, half a beef, madam.
There
you are, darling.
Thank you.
Superb.
Can I put that there for you?
Yeah.
You're happy? Okay, perfect. Thank you. That almost didn't make it to the rest. How we doing?
Fantastic. You could probably work a little bit harder.
I can't. It's only a...
just a little bit, but your time is coming. You better get out there.
Is that ham with you?
I know. You better get cracking.
Meatloaf, yep.
Would you like receipt?
No, thank you. You have your other vegetables.
Meatloaf. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Little puddle of gravy there.
You,
there you are. So you do when you're little. You got a little island.
Look at that.
Okay, you want good? Is there anything else you need?
Yeah, good to do.
How's it going?
Brilliant. I love it.
How is it?
That's good beef, man. Oh, yeah.
Everything's so fresh. I mean, there isn't anything here I wouldn't like to eat. And everybody's lovely. I'm very happy here. This is country. Bring it on.
Fundamentally, it's like a northern calf, but in Nashville. And you see, us being northern lads, it's like coming home, you know. He's knocking stuff out. I'm running around chatting to people, serving their tables, being nice. You know, it's a good demarcation of labour.
Loving it. Proper dinners for about $7. Rose, I love it here.
Yeah.
I think you have an amazing, amazing restaurant.
I don't want you to go. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you,
sorry,
thank you.
I'm a bit
thank
hot.
Yeah, hot and sweaty.
I'm just getting the hang of it, you know.
How was it behind the counter, dude? It was good.
Fiery Jack. It was good. Serving up good food. On your sir, taters, on your taters. And you put a little puddle on the top, so you got a puddle on your taters. You got your gravy on your meat, your on you, you know. It's great. I do feel as though I've arrived in Nashville now.
Inspired by the great meatloaf we tasted at Arnold's, back at base, we want to make our own.
We're doing a three meat meatloaf and three.
Which is six.
Yeah, which is twice as good as Arnold's, hopefully.
See?
Now, their meatloaf rocked. So,
in our three meat meatloaf, we have beef, we have a sausage, and we have minced pork.
What I'm going to do is fry off the trinity of onion, celery, carrot, and two cloves of garlic.
So, I've stripped the sausage skins from the sausage meat, and I'm just putting the minced pork and minced beef in. Just give it a little squidge with your hands just to push the meat together.
It's nice and translucent.
Once the veggies are sweated down, add them to the meat mix.
With the cayenne pepper or chilli powder, one teaspoon is safe. And now let's add some thyme. You can use fresh thyme or dried.
There's a lovely floral note to thyme, isn't
it? Thank you, mon frère. There you go, pal.
Right. When you're working with your hands, it's nice because you can feel that all of those spices and all of those vegetables are evenly distributed through the meat.
And the three meats work really well together. It's a really good kind of meat to fat flavour. There's a lot of ingredients in it, but they all have their place. Again, it's an American thing, but ketchup. I don't know, but it works. Three tablespoons and one tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce.
You see,
it's good.
The texture of it, you want it to be firm. Don't worry if it's a bit sloppy, because it's time for the breadcrumbs.
And to make his life even more miserable, Mr. Chucky.
Lovely. Right.
Next, we've got a heap of finely chopped flat-leaf parsley.
You see, can you see where we're going with it? All these layers of flavours come together in a lovely meatloaf of love.
And here we go again. It's interesting, though, when they talk about a meat and three here. You know, we have meat and two veg at home. It's not necessarily three veg. It can be like macaroni cheese or, I don't know, pumpkin. It is like a proper meal, I think is what it means, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Next, add salt and pepper to taste.
I just think that black pepper and meat of any description can't be beaten.
Yeah, lush, man.
Look at that, eh?
Right.
It's like a Quatermass experiment.
Give that a paddle. Come to life.
And this is the good bit now, is to shape it into an attractive loaf shape. A loaf that you are, in fact, going to cut slices. Big doorsteps full of bovine perfection.
Try and keep it as uniform as you can because you want it to cook uniformly.
Hey, loving your work, Michelangelo.
It's good, isn't it? Lovely. Yeah. Lovely, lovely, lovely.
The final touch of gorgeousness, we finish it off with a glaze and some demerara sugar. Four tablespoons of ketchup, one more tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce, and some demerara sugar. And this will caramelise it with a good sticky crust.
Pour the glaze over the loaf and put it in the oven for 45 minutes at 180 degrees.
Yes! Look at that.
Oh, mega.
It's like an alligator rising from the swamp.
Yes.
Yes. Now, we want to get this out in a wanna. This is a loaf. This is a joint.
You're going to... Oh, look at that, baby.
It is, isn't it? Now, let's go down for the gravy. I'm going to sprinkle a couple of tablespoons of flour, a jug of beef stock.
And you just dribble a little in at a time. Let the flour absorb the liquid.
Well, that's proper gravy. That's all the juices from the three meats, all the spices, and a bit of caramelisation across the nation from that demerara sugar.
It's starting to get a little bit of a sheen on it, so that's lovely, and it's starting to thicken.
They love gravy in these parts. Look at that. That's a lovely cutter. It's almost like a tureen, isn't it? Mm. It's juicy.